New research by the University of New Hampshire and State Department of Fish and Game are now providing a look at winter ticks and their effects on New Hampshire's moose.
We have radio collared 50 new moose every year. After the first year, the majority of those are calves. So we know the fate of these animals.
Professor Pete Pekins tells us winter ticks carry no disease, and in this case, it's all about loss of blood. 50,000 ticks can be found on one moose at any given time.
Clearly, that leads to death from acute anemia and massive weight loss.
70% of calves are dying, and when it comes to the adults, their bodies are weakened.
So they rarely die from the ticks, but they're compromised physiologically, so they'll have fewer calves, and their successive years of reproduction has declined.
The research for this study has been going on since 2002, and it will continue this fall. Researchers will be looking into how big the tick population actually is.
This whole story is really driven by climate change, and the impact of climate change is that winters are starting later and later, and so this just gives this parasite more time to latch onto a moose.
Pekin says the winter tick can also latch onto the white-tailed deer, but it's not having the same devastating effects.
Deer are what we call social groomers. They tend to clean themselves, and deer can actually get to any part of their body with their mouth, and they can remove ectoparasites, so this tick's on the outside.
Unfortunately for the moose, it's only going to get worse before it gets better. The good news is that people don't have to worry about getting bitten.
There's really no human impact here other than the sad story for New Hampshireites that our moose herd is dealing with this.
In Durham, Kristen Carosa, WMUR News 9.